another bad dream, Yuri. Put that rotten thing out of your mind. That tangled mess can't hurt you.
Be gone. There is nothing more.
There you are. The exalted timbre of the bell has reached these ears of mine. Gracious, the starry sky is wondrous tonight indeed. Only your fate shines brighter. But fate can be a strange thing indeed. The hanging bell you sounded was not the one on the map I gave you. The bell you found was in fact here. Please take a second look at the original map, and may the gleaming stars guide you evermore. Yulan. Well, I hope that she behaved, at least. The poor girl has overcome grave misfortune. Her tongue can be sharp at the best of times, but don't think that makes her a bad person. It's no surprise her little sister, too, has a heart of gold. I fear that you have borne witness to the whole of it. The conceits, the hypocrisy of the world built upon the Erd Tree. The follies of men. Their bitter suffering. Is there no hope for redemption? The answer, sadly, is clear. There never was any hope. They were each of them defective. Unhinged from the start. Marika herself. And the fingers that guided her. And this is what troubles me. No matter our efforts, if the roots are rotten, then we have little recourse. Ever young Mikkola saw things for what they were. He knew that his bloodline was tainted, his roots mired in madness, a tragedy if ever there was one. That he would feel compelled to renounce everything. And the blame lay squarely with the mother. Stars guide you evermore. Oh, hello. Is something the matter? May the gleaming stars guide you evermore.
How did you... Did Count Ymir reward you with that? Then I see you have gained his trust, and therefore mine. I am Yolan. The knight is yours now to wield. Don't get the wrong idea. We are neither friends nor confidants. I am merely honoring Count Ymir's wishes. Enough of you. Enough of you.